Four Das grunts are gathered inside this spacious chamber, rigging explosives to a large heap of bolts. You have a chance to find out more about the strange artifact that they were trying to unearth. Lever, triggering an explosion that flattens the remaining debris as the roar of the blast dies away. You hear a familiar voice coming from the platform above you. Is that Malik the gnome? Malik calls to you from the platform.
Thank you for clearing out the dust for me. It was a great help. Those fools had no idea what they were dealing with.
The friendly gnome transforms before your eyes. A Rakshasa.
Soon, my name will be known for all the corvair.
The portal opens, and fiends flood into the room.
Now this portal in Hyber is mine. Demons, do my bidding.
The Rakshasa lets out a shrill gasp, surprised that you managed to best him in combat.
This can't be. The world must remember my name.
The ornate artifact shatters, the portal dissipates, and the remaining demons are thrown back into the depths of Kyra. One demon falls, but wait, another streams out of the portal in its place.
Worshippers kneel before a makeshift altar. In their prayers, the cultists offer their service to the avenging Forge Wraith and implore the creature to punish those who have wronged them. The High Priestess spots you. Intruders, no matter. You will not deny us our vengeance on the city above. The High Priestess seems strangely untroubled by her imminent death. My spirit will only make our master stronger. He cannot be evaded. He cannot be bargained with. Vengeance will be his. As the Forge Wraith falls, shocked voices cry out throughout the cavern. The cult is destroyed, and the city is now safe from their schemes. Yet this was not the only Forge Wraith. More still lurk in the cults, driven by their never-ending thirst for vengeance.
Muffled moans draw your attention to the south. Perhaps this is the source of the zombie invasion. You feel a chill in the air. The draft seems to be coming from the western tunnel. The chill of the cavern gives way to warmer, more humid air as you ascend higher. The familiar musty smell is stronger. The room opens out to reveal what appears to be a makeshift temple, littered with the spores that create the red musk zombies. At the room's center is an unusual-looking mine. With a shudder, you realize this bullet is covered in galvanized spores. All of the spores responsible for creating these abominations.
My prospective investor was not impressed. His objection? My prototype cost as much to make as the skilled workman earned in a year. The cost was due to the counter crystal, of course. I had to find another way. A cheaper way. you manage to disable the device, halting the flow of frosty air. You can feel warmth seeping back into the cave, a sign that things are returning to normal. Familiar sound reverberates throughout the sewer. The wet slither of slimes. Into the main trash disposal room. There's a blood-curdling shriek from beyond the door, followed by a deep rumbling that sounds strangely. This massive chamber is filled with refuse from the upper city. In the middle of the dev room stands a grotesque lumbering beast. The trash devours the Yotiug. Unfortunately, Yotiug topples to the trash-littered floor. The door to the west opens. Gnome scavenger steps through to retrieve her device. returned the missing arcane assistant to the gnome scavenger.
Flames all around. I found a ramp leading up, but it turned out that that ramp went nowhere. All I could do was stand up there on the walkway and look down at the flames below. Fire! Fire! I shouted. I was too high up for anyone to hear me.
Thank you. You expected to find Forge personnel hard at work in this wing. Instead, you see an old woman pacing back and forth while muttering to herself. This cavern is bare aside from two circular doors, one of which stands open. You'll have to navigate the forge by using the pipe system. Hostile security drones patrol the pipes. It looks like the lost students have triggered the wing's alarm system. Teleport the hapless student back to the entrance. A sudden gust pushes upward and out of the pipe. The oppressive heat in this corridor radiates from the sealed room at the end of the hall. You teleport the hapless student back to the entrance. A magma brute has taken up residence in this cavern. It lumbers towards you, and so do its friends. Tells you that the last student was taken captive by Forge security and brought to a holding cell. You'll have to go there to resolve the situation. Magma Group is reduced to a pile of smoldering rocks. You teleport the hapless student back to the entrance. You fall down a chute and tumble out of the maze of pipes. little guardian into a pile of debris. Unlock the security door so I can get out of here. Careful though, pulling the wrong lever will summon the guardian. With a final clink, locks holding Chance in his cell spring open. Now to rescue the errant student and escape before he gets you into any more trouble. You teleport the hapless student back to the entrance.